Okay, now we will show you how to take readings in the total station. After setting up the device, after you level, same in the previous procedure and in the digital theodolite procedure, you level the tripod above the point. You see here now the laser is centered. Then you level the screws. First you start with the small bubble under here. Under the device, you can see it. Yes, you can see it here. Now this is leveled already. And you start by, after, when you reach that level point, this will appear once you turn it on, and you level the device here by adjusting slowly and clicking OK. You'll see once you click OK, the laser is gone, but it is centered on the X. This is our point O, and the second points are, since we are usually using distances, measuring distances, we need to set up prisms. The prisms are set up in this way. This is point A. This prism is installed or set up above point A exactly, as you see here. This is point A. It's centered. It's centered through an optical plummet sight in the device. And here this is point B, and you can see here the point B also centered through the optical plummet. Let's go to the prism so we show you the part of the prism. The prism is a mirror prism wherever you look, as you can see the reflection of the camera here. Wherever you look, always you'll have the center of the center of the looking, or here in this case the camera lens is always in the center. Wherever I move the device, my recording device, always the camera is in the center. And you see that here it has a orange color reflector where you can see from far the point. And here you have same base plate that needs to be leveled correctly. And here you need to also level the, you have same procedure of leveling the theodolite. You have to level the bubble, the horizontal bubble, this one. And here you can see the eyesight, the optical plummet, where you can see it is centered. I don't know if it is, yeah, it is on the X now. Okay. Once we center the, we set up the prism above the X exactly, above this point, and we center point B, we can take, this point V, we can take the readings. So let's go back to the total station where we can take the reading. Yes, just let me adjust the reflection. Yeah, now I will center the device on point A and zero the horizontal angle. Yeah, a little bit far, this is enough. I can start by the optical plummet, optical side, sorry, on the top. Then I can look through and adjust the focus. So I can see my point. Now I'm exactly on the point, just a little bit up. Okay. Now it is adjusted on the point A. I hope we can show you. You can see how it looks like. And the laser is appearing also. You can see here the X of the crosshair is in the prism X directly. Now this is set. Now let me just adjust yes, now we can set zero the horizontal angle, and we can take the reading of the vertical angle if we want it. Now we can record this. Then so far we don't, since this is just a measurement, so we'll not do any jobs in the total station. We'll just take the measurement directly from here and the measure distance. So now if you want to measure the distance between this point A and the prism, we need to go here and switch to program and click measure. You'll see a sound, then you'll see measurement. This is 3.737 meter, the units. So we can record also this distance between point O down this, okay, and point A there, the prism itself, under the prism. Okay, now let's proceed to the second point B, which is that one. Okay, down. And let's switch the screen to the Theo and just move the device until point A, point B, excuse me. The prism should be facing the total station, otherwise we'll have some error, and we, yes, now since we've fixed it there, we will see the horizontal angle measurement. We can take this, and we can see the vertical angle measurement. We can take this, and for the distance measurement we click on the program, as you can see here. Let me zoom, and we click measure. It is 4 meter 0.025. Okay, I think this is clearer. 4 meter 0.025. Okay, you can record this measurement to do the required calculation. This is just a sample between two lines, an angle between two lines. Usually we repeat this for a closed or open traversing, where we repeat this, for example, 4 times, 5 times, depending on the angles inside that closed or open loop traverse. And this is all. Thank you for watching.